already at George's on Perkins Road. At Mike Anderson's on Highland, the channel is locked on TV 2. It's restaurant night on We Play Baton Rouge. And now the star of We Play Baton Rouge, Pat Shingleton.
I found it. Hi, everybody, and welcome to We Play Baton Rouge. It's really great to be here with you again on this Saturday. Another great group in the studio audience. Hope you're enjoying everything at home. And we kind of wanted to start something out today with,
if I can make it there, I'm gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you.
Baton Rouge, Baton Rouge.
And if I can make it there, I'm gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you.
Baton Rouge, Baton Rouge. Frankie Sinatra, right here in our really big shoe. Yes, indeed, Frankie Sinatra. Here now, the host of We Play Baton Rouge, Pat Shingleton. Boy, I'll tell you what, the people were picking the music category a lot, you know? I had lessons from the Frank Sinatra. How'd it sound? Pretty good, huh? Okay, thanks anyway. Welcome to We Play Baton Rouge, the game show made in your backyard. With game show hosts you may have thrown out of your backyard. Now, we start our game with an explanation of the rules. Let's go ahead and do that. Folks, you will find on our game board three categories that will randomly appear in here. Now, when those categories rapidly mix and scramble and move around, you'll hear this. And then it happens to stop. Now, both contestants have the opportunity to pick, like, universities or history or music. Now, when they pick that particular category, I, in turn, ask them a question related to the category. Now, if they correctly answer the question, then they move across a series of well-known Baton Rouge streets. Now, you know where Jefferson Highway is? Answer it correctly, you got College. Answer it correctly, you get Acadian. But if you happen to miss a question, you'll hear this sound. That's the sound. And then you either have the opportunity of taking the other contestant could take that exact same question, or it's back to the game board. Then across Park. Then across East, over Highland. Now the contestant reaching the studios of TV2 first. That's the winner. On this side, folks, we have Perkins. We have Lee. We have Stanford. We have Dalrymple. And we have Texas Street. Over Highland, right to the studios of TV2. And as I told you, watch Texas Street. There's a lot of cops out there. Okay, now tonight, we have another group in here. And it's a group, a couple of people that you probably know very, very well. Now, how many times have you been to a Baton Rouge well-known restaurant and seen maybe these two people? Well, here's Gary King with the introduction of our contestants. Gary.
Okay, Pat, on restaurant night, we welcome from George's on Perkins, Doug Kosman.
Douglas!
Doug has a record for wolfing down more of George's well-known fries than the other guys. He enjoys collecting stray dogs, chasing stray dogs, and growing zucchini squash. He's an avid beer bottle cap collector. Here's Doug Kosman.
All right, Doug, how you doing? Oh, look at that. Doug brought in Georgia's famous Big Burger. Right, Doug?
World famous, Pat.
And here's the world famous French fries.
You're right.
Those are onion rings. No, George makes those good French fries. He takes, you know, most of the places you get the frozen French fries, he does the whole potato.
Cuts them all, skin and everything.
Okay, now they said in the introduction that you collect stray dogs. How many stray dogs do you have at home now?
Last count, 975.
975 stray dogs? I don't believe it. Well, I'm going to tell you something right now. You have a real tough competitor tonight, Doug. Who do we have going against Doug? Gary King, who is it?
From Mike Anderson's on Highland, Pat, here's Mary Wilton.
Hi, Mary.
Mary enjoys beating up tall guys with wiffle ball bats, harassing security guards, and skipping class at LSU on a regular basis. She maintains the earthworm farm at Mike Anderson's and loves to imitate Curly on the Three Stooges. She's Mary Wilton.
Hi, Mary. Good to have you. Okay, now, Mary,
You really skip a lot of classes out at LSU?
Consistently.
Really? Gee. Well, what does Mike say about that? Like Mike Anderson, he's got, you know, he might give you a hard time if you do that.
As long as I'm working while I'm skipping class, he doesn't mind at all.
There you go. That's all that counts. Now, folks, before we start the game, we have the coin toss. Then we toss the categories, but now we will toss to a commercial break, and we'll be back with more of WePlay Baton Rouge. How y'all doing? I can take that for you. We start the game, folks, with the toss of a coin. And after we get the toss of the coin, you get to select. Okay, here's where we go. Now, I'm going to flip the coin. Mary, why don't you call heads or tails? What do you call
it? Heads, Pat.
Heads it is, Mary. Now, do you want to? What do you want to do?
I think I'll start with the first question.
You got it, Mary. You all right right here, Doug?
All
right, folks, it's ready. It's time for round one of We Play Baton Rouge. Now, Mary, we're going to run those categories around for you. Let's go ahead, mix, scramble, and toss the categories around. When it stops, you get to pick the category, and I, in turn, will answer the question. Products is P-R-O-D-S, and we have comics, and we have words. Which one do you like?
How about comics?
Okay, let's see what we have under comics for your first question. Here's the question. These words, Mary, are Bugs Bunny's favorite expression. What are the words?
What's up, Doc?
That's right! What's up, Doc? Incidentally, Bob Clampett, Bugs' creator, borrowed the saying from the line, "What's up, Duke?" that was said by Carol Lombard to William Powell in the 36th movie, My Man Godfrey. So a little tidbit there for you. But you have your first three, Perkins. It is now Doug's turn. You're heading for Jefferson. And all those people, Georges, are watching. Let's scramble those categories for you. And when it stops, you can pick this time, Doug, buildings, music, or people.
Pat, I'm going to try music.
All right, let's see what we have for you under music. Here is the first question under music. This country singer, Doug, an entertainer of the year in 1976, stutters acutely when he talks, but when he sings flawlessly. Can you name this singer?
Mel Tillis.
That's right. It's none other than Mel Tillis, and you have Jefferson. It's back over to you, Mary. You're on Perkins. You're looking for Lee, and you're also looking for a couple of days off over there at Mike Anderson's. Let's spin those categories. Where they stop, you will be able to pick this time sports, television, and history.
How about television?
All right. Under television, Mary, here is your question. He performed in the rock band Beaver and the Trappers. What TV show was he in that starred Hugh Beaumont, Barbara Billingsley, Tony Dow, and Jerry Mathers?
Could it have been Leave It to Beaver?
It's Leave It to Beaver, and you have Lee. Well, we'll leave that one to Beaver. We'll leave the next question to Doug. You're on Jefferson. You're looking for college. Let's run those categories around for you again. Doug, let's see what happens as we continue here, and you'll find this time buildings, music, and people again pops up.
Well, let's just stay with music again.
Forget it, Doug. We're giving you nothing. You can stay with music. You certainly have the option of doing that. Okay, here is your music question. Who sang this song, The Last Kiss, on the Ed Sullivan Show in the 1963 movie, Bye Bye Birdie?
Fred, I don't know, Pat.
Did you say his name was Fred, I don't know?
Yeah.
That's not it, Doug. Now it's back to you, Mary. Now, according to our rules, you can take this question or we can take you back to the game board or you can pick another category.
Let's take it back to the game board.
Okay, the answer to that question, the guy that sang The Last Kiss on the Ed Sullivan Show in the 1963 movie Bye Bye Birdie was none other than Conrad Birdie. Conrad Birdie, okay. Well, let me read it again. Hey, Mary, I'm reading the answers. You're playing the game, okay?
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. It's not. It's Conrad Birdie. Now, it's back to you. You're on Lee. You're heading for Stanford. We said you could get back to the game board, and that you can do. Let's run the categories around again for you. When they stop, you will be able to pick this time the categories of buildings, music, and people. Now, you see, now you never know what's going to pop up there, you see. And when we're after the show, I will ring Rick Vogler's neck. But let's say, okay, buildings, music, people, what looks good for you there?
It's time music.
Okay, music it is. And once again, here is the question. Under music, now this rock group, Mary, is named after a famous American city. In April of 1971, the rock group played at Carnegie Hall. and it was the first group to do so. Can you name this group for Stanford?
Could you repeat the question?
I will repeat the
just
question
the first
for
part.
You. This rock group is named after a famous American city. And in April of 1971, it was the first rock group to play at Carnegie Hall. Can you name the group for Stanford?
I have no earthly idea what it is.
I'm sorry, that's not the group. But it's back to you, Doug. You can take this question.
I'll take that question.
All right, let's read it again. This rock group is named after a famous American city. And in April of 1971 was the first rock group to play at Carnegie Hall. Can you name the group, Doug?
Chicago.
Chicago is right. Hey, now if you two look at your street signs, you'll notice, Doug, you're on College heading for Acadian. You're on Lee heading for Stanford. I'm heading for George's and Mike Anderson's. But first, we have these special commercial messages especially for you. Two of WePlay Baton Rouge. We have Doug Crossman. Doug works over and manages and helps at George's. And we have also Mary Wilton, who keeps everything in order at Mike Anderson's. And when we left, Mary, it's your turn. You're on Lee. You're heading for Stanford. Let's run those categories around for you. When it stops, you will pick yours for your next street, which is Stanford. Here we find products and comics and words. Mary, what looks good there?
Comics.
Okay, you like comics? Okay, here we go. Under the comic category, here is the question. Under cartoons, in the American Eagle, a TV cartoon squadron, Roger Ramjet's juvenile assistants were named what? Now, can you name just one of them? There were four of them.
I don't think I can.
You know, you can't name
them? I'm going to give up this early.
Okay, it's back to you, Doug. You can take the question.
Let's spin this one again.
Oh, you want to spin this one. Okay, in the American Eagle, a TV cartoon squadron, Roger Ramjet's juvenile assistants were named Yank, Doodle, Dan, and Dee.
Oh.
Okay, scramble the categories for Doug. Let's mix them up, move them around. That was a bad one. Okay, well, that's what happens when we play Baton Rouge. Buildings,
right.
Music, and people. Boy, that buildings, music, people one really locks in there an awful lot. Okay, what looks good this time to you there, Doug?
Well, for a change, let's try music.
Okay, I kind of get the impression there, Doug, that you like that music category. Here's your question. Jim Weatherly was the quarterback of the University of Mississippi who penned the hit songs Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me, Midnight Train to Georgia. What famous rock group recorded these two songs, Best Thing That Ever Happened to Me and Midnight Train to Georgia?
Gladys Knight and the Pips.
Gladys Knight and the Pips is right. You have Acadia. It's back over to Mary. You're on Lee. You're heading for Stanford. Let's run those categories around again and mix them up. What will it stop on this time? Is it going to be buildings, music, and people again? What the heck can happen here on WePlay Baton Rouge? Under buildings, music, and people, what looks good to you, Mary?
History.
History it is, and here's your...
How about buildings?
Okay, buildings, Mary, here's the question under buildings, and here is your question. This very historic Baton Rouge building was destroyed by fire in 1862 and later rebuilt. It has four battlement towers, a stained glass dome. What is the building or name the building?
Could it be the old state capitol?
The old state capitol is right. You have Stanford. It's back to Doug. Let's mix them up again for you, Doug. And I'll tell you what, will it pop up on buildings, music, and people again? If it does, I'm cutting my throat. Let's run those categories around again for them and see what happens. Will I cut my throat? No! It's products, comics, and words this time.
Let's try comics.
There was a lot of people out there hoping I would sharpen the knife. Under comics, here it is. Cartoons is also the category. Foghorn J. Leghorn, Doug, is a giant rooster that talks with a southern accent in Warner Brothers cartoons. He is noted for saying, I say, blank, son. What is the missing word that we're looking for?
My son?
I'm sorry, incorrect. Back to you, Mary. You can take the question or it's back to the game board.
Let's try the game board.
Okay, he says, I say, good night, son. He says, I say, that's great, son. Howdy or greeting, son. Any four of those were possible, but it's back to you, Mary, and it's back to the game board. Let's run them around again. Now, Will it pop up on buildings, music, and the other one? No, it's history, university, and music this time. Now, Mary, what looks good this time?
Music.
Okay, under music, here is the question. Daisy Hawkins was the original title, Mary, of this Lennon-McCartney composition. The title was later changed, and the song talks about a lonely girl. Who picked up the rice at the church? Can you name this song for Stanford?
Let's see, Eleanor Rigby?
Eleanor Rigby's right, you have Dow Ripple. And it's back over on Acadian looking for Park. Now, Doug, what do you say? Let's run the categories around again and mix them up and toss them, see what pops up this time as we continue on round two of We Play Baton Rouge. Here's products, words, and comics.
Well, let's try comics for a change again.
Okay, for some reason, Doug and Mary really like music and comics, but that's okay. That's what happens when we play Baton Rouge. Here's your question, Doug. This comic book bear was created by Walter Lantz and debuted in 1939. His girlfriend is Miranda, his mother, Paramelia, his father, Papa, and they live in Pandamania. Can you name this character?
Can I hear the question again, please?
Surely. Pat. This comic book bear was created by Walter Lantz and debuted in 1939. His girlfriend is Miranda, his mother, Paramelia, his father, Papa, and they live in Pandamania. Can you name the comic book character?
No.
Okay. That's a pretty good answer. I thought that might have been the name of it, but no, it's back to you, Mary. Take the question or it's back to the game board.
Let's go back to the game board.
Okay, back to the game board. It was Andy Panda. You remember Andy Panda? Little Andy Panda bears? You don't remember those, huh, Doug? Well, you're going to get it later. All right, back to the game board, Mary. You're on Dalrymple, heading for Texas. Last street before moving over Highland to the studios of TV2, and we find products, comics, and words.
Comics?
Okay, under the old comic category once again. What's for breakfast are the first words of this cartoon character when he awakes each morning. Is this cartoon character one of the four? Is it Yogi Bear, Foghorn Leghorn, Winnie the Pooh, or Bugs Bunny?
Winnie the Pooh?
That's exactly right. You have Texas. Okay, Doug, let's go. You're on Acadian heading for Park. Three streets to go. Mary, all you got to do is toss over Highland. We got to take care of a little bit of business. We'll be back with more right after this.
If you'd like to be a contestant on We Play Baton Rouge, all it takes is sending your name, address, phone number, and occupation to Pat Shingleton Production, 619 Jefferson Highway, Baton Rouge, 70806. And now back to the game, and Pat Shingleton.
Thank you very much, Gary King. Moving into the last round on We Play Baton Rouge. Two streets behind you are, Doug. It's your turn. Let's run those categories around. Find what happens as we continue here. Let's see what will pop up. Will it be buildings, music, and people? There are 16 possible categories in there, folks. And what is going on? That's what happens when we play Baton Rouge. What do you pick there, Doug?
Tough choice. Let's try music again.
Okay, under music, here is the question. Okay, that was a ton of bricks. That was a ton of bricks. Don't be alarmed. We always get a ton of bricks here on We Play Baton Rouge. And Bob Jolly, you're getting yours later. Now, this particular song is Lawrence Welk's theme song. It goes bump, bump, ba dum, ba dum, ba dum, ba dum, ba dum, ba dum, bump, ba dum, ba dum, bump, ba dum. What is the name? Now that's not the name, Doug. What is the name of Lawrence Welk's theme song?
Champagne Music.
Sorry, that's incorrect, Doug. Now, Mary, you can take this question. Head across Highland as the winner today, where it's back to the game board.
Thanks for having me. Back to the game board.
You're getting the question anyway. No, Lawrence, it's bubbles in the wine. Bubbles in the wine, Mary. Okay, it's back to the game board for you. You're on Texas. One street to go, Mary. Run them around again. Let's see what happens. Here we find this time universities, history, and music.
How about music, Pat?
Okay, music again is the one you like, and that's the one that you will get. World renowned as the King of Swing. This man popularized jazz in the 1930s and the 1940s. And initiated the big band era. An orchestra conductor and clarinetist, he and his band made the first jazz tour of Russia. Name this king of music.
No.
Back to you, Doug. Take the question, move to Parker's, back to the game board.
Benny Goodman.
That's exactly right, you have Park. Okay, it's back to you, Mary. Let's run those categories down. Doug ain't out of this game yet. Back to the game board. Let's see what happens as we continue to move the categories around. We find buildings, music, and people. Boy, that thing's locking in.
How about music?
Okay, under music, here is the question. Under music, we find Nellie Kelly is the name of a female fan mentioned in one of the verses of this 1908 baseball song. Can you name the song?
Nellie Kelly.
Let me repeat it. Nellie Kelly is the name of a female fan mentioned in one of the verses of this 1908 baseball song. Can you name the song?
Oh, but I'll give it a crack.
Take a guess.
Take me out to the ballpark?
That's right! You moved across island! You're our winner today! You hit it right on the money! All right, now, Doug, listen.
Tough competition, Pat.
Tough competition. I'll tell you what, I'm glad we found somebody with a PhD to go against you, because I knew. No, you played a great game.
Thank you,
there was a one question, Oberlin College, located in Ohio, was pretty good, but listen, never go home without something you can't take back to the good people at George's. Here now is Gary King with a nice consolation gift for you. Gary, what do we have?
For our consolation prize tonight, you'll receive this stereo cassette player. Yes, it's the famous Sony Walkman from New Generation. The Walkman provides listening pleasure no matter what you're doing. It includes separate volume control, rewind cue, and of course, headphones, all from New Generation. New Generation, your superstore for the 80s in Baton Rouge and in Lafayette. Total retail value of this gift is $179.95.
You'll enjoy that Sony Walkman, and when you're in there behind a bar, plug a cassette in. Heck yeah. Now, Mary, it was a good guess. Take me out to the ball game. Nellie Kelly is being one of the verses mentioned in that. And as our winner today, let me ask you this question. When was the last time that you won a brand new car?
Yesterday.
Okay, well, that's good because we got something else for you. Here's Gary King to tell us about it. Gary, what do we have for Mary?
As our winner tonight, you're taking off with us. We've arranged a special trip for you and your guest. You'll leave New Orleans International on Republic Airlines. Republic, serving more of America than any other airline. You'll visit a great American city where American International Travel selects two luxurious nights for you and your guest. American International Travel, here in Baton Rouge, and handling all of your travel needs wherever you want to be tomorrow. Back in Baton Rouge, your excursion doesn't end. When you return, you'll visit Old Italy as our guest at Gino's Restaurant. Gino's provides the taste of Old Italy in its atmosphere and especially its cuisine. Gino's, 4542 Bennington in Baton Rouge.
See, how about that, Mary? Mary said she's going to take Doug on a trip and also take him to, so you can't beat that. You're going to Gino's with her. Folks, thanks for being with us on another edition of We Play Baton Rouge. Pat Shingleton reminding you, no matter what game you're playing, you play it the best you can. Bye-bye for now.
We Play Baton Rouge is a Pat Shingleton production in association with WBRZ-TV2. Eyewitness News is up next, and join us next Saturday when... Happy Memorial Day weekend to you and yours. The TV sets are on in Broadmoor and the volume is up in Scotlandville. It's just after 5:30 in the capital city in time. We Play Baton Rouge. Here now is the star of We Play Baton Rouge, Pat Shingleton.
How you doing? Thank you very much. Welcome to We Play Baton Rouge and a big happy Memorial Day to you all out there. Hope you're enjoying your weekend. I was just over at John Mahaffey's house, ate there. Went over to Bruce Weber's house, had some nice Memorial Day dinner over there. And then I went to Andy Leopold's house. He had chopped liver. But that's what happens when we play Baton Rouge. Good to have you with us. We always start that game with the explanation of the rules. Here, take a look and see. Often, folks, we will randomly run the categories around. Now, when you hear the music stop, the board stops too, and it pops up inventions and buildings and mixed bag. Now, when you see that, the contestant can then pick a particular category. After they pick the category, I in turn ask them the question. Now, if they successfully answer the question correctly, they'll move across a series of streets, such as Jefferson Highway, you know where that is, from College and Acadian. But there's a time that if they should miss the question, they'll hear this sound. And when they hear that, the other contestant has the option, folks, of either taking that particular question or going back to the game board for another category and another question. Then across Park, then across East, over Highland, right to the studios of TV2. And on this side, we find Perkins Road, and they're almost done with that construction out there, so we should be able to move across that road pretty good today. Then Lee, then Stanford, and then Dalrymple, and then Texas Street. You know, being as it is Memorial Day, we always like to take that moment on Decoration Day to recognize those people that have been instrumental in helping this country throughout the years. And we're very happy to have two excellent guests with us today as contestants. And here's Gary King with the introduction. Gary?
For Decoration Day 1982, we're happy to welcome Bobby Pugh. Bobby's the president of the Ladies Auxiliary Unit 371 Fleet Reserve Association. She also enjoys roller derby, tightrope walking, playing her bongos, and especially chasing her husband with the lawn rake. Bobby Pugh.
Oh, Bobby. You don't chase your husband with a lawn rake. You mean there's a possibility you may be chasing him with the...
Well, it might be a fishing pole, but we'll call it a lawn rake.
That's what happens when we play Baton Rouge. Nobody. We're happy to have you with us here today. We got another great... And incidentally, you're with the Fleet Reserve. Right. And tell us just a little bit about that.
It's an organization for active duty and retired Navy, Coast Guard, and Marine.
Fantastic. So they all get together and kind of keep together and... find out what each other's
doing. Helping Baton Rouge, helping veterans.
There you go. That's great. And we have another good contestant. Who do we have this time, Gary King, going against Bobby?
Pat, say hello to another Pat, retired Lieutenant Colonel Patricia Maben. Pat is involved in recruiting in the area for the United States.